Hi everybody, this is Alchemist 2 and I'm back again with another book review. I just recently read Dreamland by David K. Randall, and it comes from his own experiences with somnambulism, and it's just such a fascinating book because it discusses the whole idea that science really doesn't understand the quote-unquote functionality of sleep and how different animals restore themselves in the night. And I actually read something interesting recently about how the mind itself will empty overnight and get rid of all the toxicity. And I thought, and how long haven't we known that? Years? But it's astonishing. It's utterly flabbergasting how little we know about the functionality of sleep and et cetera, and how important it is. And people with insomnia, oh gosh, I feel for them. I really, really do, because nobody has died yet of lack of sleep. But they really have, you know, I'd hate to be the guinea pig to be in that study. Oh, we're going to poke and prod you until you die. How about I just pass and you leave me alone? Go away. But that's probably why they haven't done it, because they're too afraid of the ethical implications of that. Yeah, I would be too. I'd be like, your family is going to be so ticked off when they realize that you're dead. I mean, you're not waking up. But it's just, oh, I can only imagine. That's why they haven't done it. I think that's the reason why they're not going to do that study. But they talk about medications for sleep and parasomnias and insomnia and somnambulism and sleep eating, sleep driving, even sleep sex. And how beds themselves know more than any other furniture on the face of the planet. It just reminds me of Kunal Nayar's memoir, when he says, if you ask any piece of furniture, I would ask the bed, because the bed probably has the most wisdom of any other furniture in the household. I thought, preach. But it talks about how easily the mind can be fooled, and how a blue light can be interpreted as just sunlight. I mean, the mind itself is very reptilian sometimes. I mean, even though we have a higher intellect, I think it goes back to the pre-mammalian brain, the more reptilian side that just operates on fight, flight, or fright, feed, or breed, etc. You know, adrenaline, cortisol, and then the melatonin cycles that we all have, a circadian rhythm. And it also talks about CPAPs, how they were invented by Sullivan, who was a man who was in New Zealand, and he invented it from a vacuum cleaner. I thought, well, that makes sense. And it was just, you know, revolutionary, still is. I mean, there's so much, and this book is just absolutely fascinating, but don't take my word for it. As LeVar Burton would say, I can't believe I just quoted that. Yes, I am a nerd. But if you're interested in onirism and anything involving that and just the whole study, people get paid to do this, which I think is pretty cool. But we know little to next to nothing, just like we know little to next to nothing about neurobiology. But we're learning. We are learning more and more as we go forward. We've only just cracked the surface. I give it 2 thumbs way up, 5 stars, hands down. By far one of the best books I've ever read, and just completely and totally transfixing throughout. Just fantabulous book. Till next time, live long, prosper. Ciao, tutti!